Hello and welcome to this latest webinar on DIEMLtdTV. This webinar is on making construction waste work. We're going to start with some basic principles on waste law in the United Kingdom. In the UK, all waste is subject to a duty of care on everyone involved in handling the waste, from the person who produces it through the persons who finally dispose or recover the waste. As individuals or companies, we can't change the law, so we've got to make legal compliance work for us. If we don't have the correct waste documentation, how can we check if we're not being overcharged? How can we demonstrate compliance to clients and the Environment Agency? And how can we plan to manage and minimise future waste? We can only plan for waste management and measure for waste from a known baseline, so keeping accurate records is vital. As we can see in the photograph, segregation of waste on a site in East Lancashire is saving the contractor and client money. When we segregate the waste, the different rates of landfill tax change. Metal and uncontaminated stone, if segregated, are charged at current 2010 rates at £2.50 a tonne landfill tax. Wood, on the other hand, is charged at £48 a tonne landfill tax, so segregation is saving money. However, if we recycle or recover these materials, we won't pay any landfill tax. Segregation of waste on site is the best option if we have the space. As you can see in the photograph, different waste streams are being collected and stored in different waste containers. Sadly, we don't live in an ideal world or work on perfect sites. How many times have you seen skips overflowing? This is not both an environmental hazard, but also can be a health and safety hazard too. Lack of space doesn't mean a lack of waste separation. Waste that is commingled can be segregated by some waste contractors either manually, as shown on the photograph on the left, or mechanically on the photograph on the right. When we receive waste transfer notes on sites, check your records. Waste separation is not always an exact science, and if we don't have the correct documentation, how can we check if we're not being incorrectly charged? How can we demonstrate compliance to our clients and the Environment Agency? And again, how can we plan to manage and minimise future waste? If you're struggling to get this information from your waste contractor, find a waste contractor that will. Now we know what waste we're producing, what shall we do with the information? Well, we now know what we're spending on waste. Therefore, we can price waste into future projects more accurately. We can also demonstrate compliance and performance at tender, and we can also demonstrate continual improvements in both environmental and waste management issues. Linking this into site waste management plans, we can set more accurate targets, and therefore we can price for waste more accurately. And careful planning allows opportunities for waste cost savings to be identified. We're now going to look at three scenarios that are common on construction sites. The first one is, I'm a subcontractor, I don't write site waste management plans. The main contractor, if the site's applicable for a site waste management plan, is likely to ask you what waste you are producing on site. The second scenario is, I'm a main contractor, but I don't want to write a site waste management plan. Well, as of April 2008, site waste management plans are a legal minimum requirement in England for construction projects costing more than £300,000 excluding VAT under the Site Waste Management Plan Regulations 2008. So if your project is of that value, it is a legal requirement to have a site waste management plan. The final scenario is, my project is less than £300,000. Would a site waste management plan work for me? Well, the answer could be yes, because you know what you're spending on waste, you can price waste into future projects more accurately, you can demonstrate your compliance and performance at tendering waste management issues, and you can also demonstrate continual improvements in these areas. You might want to ask yourself, when should I start planning for waste? Well, opportunities for the use of recycled materials need to be started at the project conceptualisation stage, as a later start may end up in waste minimisation being a time versus money scenario. The earlier you start, therefore, the earlier you can look at options and work with the Environment Agency on getting exemptions for the project. Let's all remember that communication is the key throughout the project for effective waste management, from dealing with the Environment Agency for waste exemptions, to dealing with designers, to dealing with subcontractors, to dealing with trade staff on site. Communication is the key. To conclude, let's make construction waste work to save money and increase profit, improve your environmental performance on site. You may be able to win work through your environmental performance, and also, and most importantly, comply with the law.